Welcome back to Colorado Sports Connection. We're talking with Carl Mecklenburg, and we're also talking about his book, Heart of a Student Athlete. Now, Carl, we were talking about in the Super Bowl, come up a little bit short in all three of them.
Right.
But yet, you use that as a motivation also to talk about in your book and your motivational speaking.
Sure. Yeah. You know, it's tough when you don't win. Everybody wants to win. The idea that the mission is perfection. You know, you want everything to go exactly right. Sometimes they don't. The only way to fix that is look at what went wrong, set some goals around what went wrong, and then get back at it. That perseverance, that persistence, to me is really what success is all about. To me, success is overcoming obstacles on the way to your dreams. And if you're not running into obstacles, if things don't go wrong, then maybe you're not pushing hard enough.
Now, also when you're here, you also have something, your foundation, the Reach Foundation.
Right.
Talk a little bit about that and what you're doing for the children. Is it outside of Colorado as well?
No, it's actually in Denver.
Okay.
The Reach Foundation works with Denver Public Schools. The graduation rate in Denver Public Schools, unfortunately, is less than 50%.
Okay.
And the kids who don't graduate, more often than not, don't graduate because they can't read. We've gone into the elementary schools and incentivized and challenged the kids to read. We got them reading 100 minutes a week outside of class. And once they get over that hump and get the reading down and have that part of their life, then they're going to be able to be successful in school and to be successful in life.
Now, what motivated you to start something like this?
You know, I was raised with an understanding that I'd do something socially significant with my life. My dad's a doctor. My mom is Deputy Secretary of Health and Human Services in the Reagan administration. I ended up playing a game for a little while. This has allowed me, not only from a speaking standpoint, the book standpoint, but the foundation, too, to really make an impact in the community that I love and that I live in.
Now, when people go to the Reach Foundation and if they want to volunteer, what is it that they can do to help out?
You know, there's all kinds of things you can do. We have functions, and actually just going in the schools and helping out in the schools. You know, the teachers are overwhelmed with the numbers, but you can do that through our foundation. You go to carlmecklenburg.net, and it's got the Reach Foundation there. You can contact Pam with our foundation and find out where you can help out.
Now, when you're doing these speaking engagements and you're talking about the Reach Foundation, how much does it help by being a former Denver Bronco?
You know, it opens doors. It's interesting, though. It's kind of a double-edged sword because there's a lot of ex-athletes out there speaking. But for the most part, they don't take it seriously like I do. And this is my job. This is my profession now. A lot of guys, it's just like something that they do, you know, if somebody calls them out. And they don't necessarily do a very good job. So I get the recognition, but I also get the speakers bureaus and meeting planners who have been burned by a guy, you know, showing up not prepared or showing up late or whatever. So I've got to stand on my own two feet to be successful in this business, kind of like I did in professional football. I was one of the last picks in the draft. No one expected me to make it, and I made it, and I made it, and I worked, and I worked. It wasn't just making it. It was I was going to be the best, and that's the way I approached the speaking thing, too.
And, you know, that definitely is a great point right here. You talk about being the best. Let's talk a little bit about this 1983 draft, because they say that's probably one of the best drafts ever in the NFL.
That's why it was such a late draft pick, right?
Exactly. I mean, the 1983 draft, number one overall, John Elway. Number two, Eric Dickerson, Kurt Warner. In that draft, too, you've got Jim Kelly at number 14, Dan Marino as 27, number 28, Darryl Green, and then 310, Carl Mecklenburg. So that just proves that people out there, you put your mind to something and you work, and we were talking earlier, don't make excuses.
No, yeah, you got to be accountable. You got to be honest and forgiving. That's one of my keys to success. You got to be honest with yourself and self-evaluation. Forgive yourself if things don't go right. Set some more goals, get back to where you want to go, and pursue that passion.
You know, I can't believe that, you know, the 30 minutes is upon us already, but I'd like to take this moment and allow you to say something about the Mile High fans and what they meant to you personally.
You know, to come to Colorado, and I could have gone anywhere, like I said earlier, and to play in front of these fans and to be taken into the Colorado community the way my family has been taken and the way I've been accepted and revered, it's a wonderful thing. I that's why I'm still here. You know, it was 1983. It's been a long time. I'm still here, and I don't ever see leaving.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, a Ring of Famer, not only on the field, but off the field as well, Carl Mecklenburg. Carl, have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. That goes to all of you out there too. And we'll see you again on January 5th. We're gonna take 2 weeks off. That way Trey can do all his Christmas shopping for his family. And we'll be back and we'll see you right here on Colorado Sports.